Hello and welcome to a Tabletop Bellhop Intergalactic Cardboard Coat Check. I am Mo Tuzano, the Tabletop Bellhop, your cardboard concierge, working with you to make your game nights better by showing off what you get in the box for this. This is Star Wars the Deckbuilding Game from Fantasy Flight Games, a licensed Star Wars game for two players that people have told me has similarities to Star Realms, which has me kind of excited because I really like Star Realms. This is a two-player deck-building game, but a deck-building, not deck pre-construction. This is not a collectible card game. This is not a living card game. This is you each start with your own starter deck of crappy cards, and they're the same cards with different names, and you're buying from a market in the middle, trying to defeat the other player and keep balance in the force. So this is, again, from Fantasy Flight Games. This was a birthday gift that I am looking forward to checking out. So thank you for the gift. I'm not going to call out who got it at this particular time, but thank you for the gift. Step one to playing the game, though, is opening it up. So here you have the box, which is surprisingly thick. From what I know what's in here, I'm not sure quite why the box is so large, but I guess it's for you know, table presents. You can kind of see the back here. Looking at the back, it really reminds me of the old collectible card game. Though this is, again, this is not a collectible game at all. This is a two-player only deck-building game, which is important to know. You cannot play this one. Well, as far as I know, according to the box, it's two-player. Maybe there's some way if you buy multiple sets. Oh, it has an insert. Okay. Yeah, it's not so bad, except... Okay, yeah, there's a trough to put tokens. I was going to say, I'm like, this is all the cards you get for that deep well. That's going to be disappointing. All right. Surprisingly thick rule book. Some, of course, nice artwork on the cover there with Luke and Vader showing you the very components, which we're going to get through. There's not a lot to see. How to set up. Note the decks are actually different, but they have different starting bases. These are the recommended ones. More do come in the game. That you can, and there's some advanced rules you're probably going to want to try if you're an experienced gamer. You've got a force track. We'll get all this. Here's how to set up your play area. It's pretty simple, to be fair. You've got your standard market in the middle. You've got your bases that you're trying to destroy of your opponents. You've got your deck, your discards, and then a force tracker over here. Core concepts, deck building, what is it, balance of the force, how to read the cards, kind of everything you expect in a game, a deck building game. Play cards, purchase cards, use cards' abilities, committing to an attack, resolving an attack, winning the game. So the core rules are 21 pages. That's significant. I don't know why there's a sample shot of a sample game, I guess, showing you where to do your things. Typical Fantasy Flight, we finish the rules, then get to the additional rules section. So it's more than that. This full thing has rules all the way to the end. You're looking at 27 pages before you get to advanced game modes. And then optional rules. I have heard that playing with this, paying off neutral cards is like a must do. That's like the game really shines once you do that. FAQ in the back. Again, I feel like I'm holding a Fantasy Flight game because I am. Disappointingly, instead of using the back for some kind of reference or you know, walk through the plays, they used it to advertise a different game. Not that I'm adverse to anyone. So here you have your different starter decks, your starter troops. We'll go through those first. Then you have the force tracker, it looks like. Oh, and the generic person you can always buy. Then you have cubes, which we'll get to in a second, and then the market deck here, and then more market deck. I'm assuming two parts to the market deck, which of course include various things. So we'll do these really quick because it's nice and simple. There is three different colors of cubes: yellow, pink, and white. Yellow are resources. They're the crates you collect. Pink is damage you place onto your cards, and white is for tracking the force on the force tracker, which is somewhere in here. One of these, it's right here, part of it. You can see it. Nope, not that one. There, that's part of the force tracker. So cubes, plastic cubes, not wooden cubes. Simple enough, nice enough component. Let's go with the rebels. So your standard rebel deck at the start of the game starts with two rebel troopers, bunch of alliance shuttles, and a temple guardian. What I'm going to hold up here is I got to say the art is rather nice. It's Star Wars. I am a Star Wars fan, but that is nice artwork. I don't know if it's unique to this game. Then you have the bases. These are the planets that you own that you're trying to collect. So the rebels start with Dantooine, Mon Cala, Tatooine, Solus, Yavin 4, Hoth, Bespin, Dagobah, Alderaan, and Jedha. And as a fan, I have to call it, I like that they're mixing new and old in here. So you've got planets from different eras of the movies. So this is the Rebel deck. I'm not sure why there's all this deep well underneath of space, but this is going to be very similar. This is the Empire deck, which functionally, at least for the starting deck cards, is identical. I don't know if the planets are the same, because the planets have different health bases. The bases have different health. So you're going to have two stormtroopers and a bunch of Imperial shuttles and one unique card, which is an Inquisitor. Then you're going to have all the planets. And again, I don't know if these match off. So you have Lothal, Corellia, Coruscant, Death Star, Endor, Mustafar, Cafrene. There's one I didn't even know off the top of my head. Ord Mantell, Kessel. Is that one stuck? Nope. And Rodia. And what I didn't show is the backs. I should have. The backs of the planets are not randomized, but these backs should match everything because it's a deck builder. So here you go, the Empire deck. Then you have the Outer Rim Pilot card, which is the card that's always available to purchase for two resources. Anyone who's played Star Realms will be familiar with that concept. He produces two resources, and he has an ability that you can banish him to do one damage. Like I said, this people say it's like Star Realms. Yep. So there's a bunch of those. Those are always available. There is a summary cards. Cool. I didn't know that was in there. So a little bit better. I'm less disappointed there's nothing on here now that I see this. I am actually going to split those onto those two decks. We're going to put the Outer Rim Pilot standing up here. And this is the, I was expecting cardboard, pretty cheesy force track that you're going to put that cube on. And as you play the game, of course, the force starts with the rebels and then can get pulled back and forth. Flimsy kind of thing. I would like a nicer one of these, but fair. Fits in the box. Then we're going to have the market cards. So this is stuff you're going to be able to buy, and I am not going to show you every card, but again, I appreciate the art. We got Chewbacca, Jyn Erso, U-Wings, and these should be split between Rebel. You also, there are two different types of cards in this. So there are units, and then there are capital ships. And you'll note they face different ways, and if you played Space Base, you got a pretty good idea of why. There should be a mix of Rebel cards in here and Empire cards. And I got to say, before you play the first time, shuffle well, because they're literally sorted together. Hold these up so you can see some of them. Yeah, I'm loving the artwork here. General Veers. Okay, I will say the art is repeated from other Fantasy Flight games. I know that because I've seen that picture before. I think it was an Imperial Assault. Wow, Boba Fett's actually listed as Imperial instead of Neutral. That's surprising. Star Destroyer, Darth Vader. So far, these are all just Rebel and Empire cards. These may be all the neutral that either side can purchase. Now, there's an interesting thing in this game. You can't purchase your opponent's cards, but you can defeat them and get rewards for defeating them. You never actually attack the cards in the opponent's deck, which I thought was very fascinating. Okay, that didn't want to cut well. So let's get this open. So these may be just generic, so that could be the Rebels and the Empire. Yeah, so far these are all neutrals that anyone can purchase. Yep, so that's what this is. This whole set of cards are the neutral characters, the scum and villainy and other factions. Oh no, there's some Rebels. So mostly neutral. There's some more Rebels cards here. There are duplicates, which is interesting to know. So there are some that, like, I'm seeing three different X-Wings here, which makes sense. That's it. Everything you get in Star Wars, The deck building game. I am a huge fan. There's room for expansions here, clearly. Another one people want to know, sleep cards, easily. Same with here. You got room. Sleep cards should fit fine. I am going to put that flat as it was. Little confused by how deep this well is. Like, is that literally just to hold it up? Box was more filled than I expected, though. When I picked it up, based on the weight, I actually thought it wasn't going to be. There you have Star Wars, the deck building game from Fantasy Flight Games. Two-player, dueling, deck building card game. Start with standard decks. Use resources to purchase cards from the middle, as well as attack cards in the middle, trying to destroy your opponent's bases by doing damage to them. No directly attacking players. Again, does seem very familiar to other very popular deck building games, which honestly makes sense. There's a reason those other games are popular. Really looking forward to checking this one out. This is the kind of game my wife and I should love. This type of thing we play together at coffee shops, bars, and pubs. Speaking of which, we just did a podcast episode about that. So if you're looking for some other date night game recommendations, check out the Tabletop Bellhop Gaming Podcast, which you can find on your podcatcher of choice. And if you're interested in seeing that recorded, you can actually join us Wednesday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern on Twitch, twitch.tv/tabletopbellhop, because we record every episode live on Twitch. Should be there every Wednesday. We got to take a time off now and then, but in general, we try to go live every Wednesday. Thank you very much for joining me, not so long ago, right now, but in a galaxy far, far away.